going, guys? Jinsy here, and today I'm at Dynamic Indoor Golf, and I'm going to be showing you as many photos and videos as I can of me getting my clubs fitted for me. So I hope you guys enjoy this quick video, and I'll see you guys later.
You and me are bored of regularities, living all the dreams, playing all the games, and getting high on love. They can chase us down, but we will always win. Leading every dance, feeling every touch, and getting high on love. We're invincible.
Heavier in the shaft, but we've got to be careful that we don't go too stiff, because your peak height, your spin is actually very good. Very good. You're going to have a bit of a transition change when you drop into your longer rounds to your shorter rounds, because you're going from cast to forge. So your distance is going to be a little bit sporadic, which we need to quieten that down a little bit. Depends what your speed's going to be like. As you warm up and as you start hitting it a little bit harder, you start losing your dispersion because these are just too soft on the tips of the foot. So what I'm going to do is put you into a slightly lighter shaft, slightly heavier shaft, sorry. A little bit stiffer, but not too stiff on the tip. See if we can quieten that dispersion down a little bit further. Area here as tight as possible. Yeah?
Yeah.
Whereas if we have a look at the other irons, what we'll see is we'll see how your peak height's fluctuating a little bit. So you've got 30, 35, 37, 34, 35, 36. So we'll just drop the peak height a little bit. It's going to stabilise your numbers a bit more. We're going to move up a full swing wave. When people fit you for golf clubs, they fit you off the shelf with clubs that have got these adjustable tips on. When the club actually gets made from tailor made, they'll ask for a swing weight. So the swing weight's equally as important as getting the right shot. We just keep plugging different shafts in here, the weight's changing all the time, the weight of the shaft's changing. So this is going to take it from D1 up to D2.5. Okay. Heavier the shaft, heavier the head's going to move the balance point in the shaft. So it'll feel lovely. Brilliant. Really good. Really good. Brilliant. Brilliant. Excellent. So much better then. So much better. Yes, it's not going as far because obviously it's fading, but it's a great way of neutralising your ball flight.
Yeah.
Playing with your two different club paths. It's all it is. Nice thing about it is you can do it, you know. And also when you have a club fitting, it's super, super important to always play about with it. Try and hit some low ones, try and hit some draws, try and hit some fades, because it's no good building your one-dimensional golf club. When you're out on the golf course, how often do you need a straight shot? Never. You always have some kind of shape in it. Good. go. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. Perfect fade. This is pretty extreme what I'm asking you to do here, but the only reason why I'm asking you to do it, if you look at the screen, you're almost half the height of the ball flight. So all you're doing is you're just playing around with different ball flights and understanding what you need to do rather than trying to overcomplicate. Tendency here, if we draw an equator line through your driver, nearly everything comes quite high out here. Right. So that shows me two things. It's we're working underneath it, exactly what we're explaining with the irons. But if we have a look at the face of a driver here, and if we have a look on M1, we'll see that actually the sweetest part of M1's face is actually out of this line here, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? So if you're hitting everything above this equator line here, then we're in bother because we're going to lose a load of ball speed, aren't we? Yeah? Which is creating it again a little bit underneath it and just picking the ball up in the air. So, I mean, we're launching some of these at 23 degrees. We need to get at least 7 degrees worth of launch off that. So, we need to get a much flatter flight with the driver because you're giving up a lot of distance. Definitely take that, by the way. How long we got?
126, and you already got half of that.
126?
No, 26.
Seconds?
Yeah.
Clear this up in the black line, alright?
Yep.
So, pull that handle down. You square?
Yep.
Yeah? Right, you need to pull a roller tail off. And it'll stop, okay? You rip it off from here. And measure your grip on your shaft. Yeah?
Yeah.
So and your tape wants to go there. Keep your tape tight. And then get your top layer on. Just there. And from there, just fold under with your hands. And the other side. And you're going to let that finger off and cover the shaft. Tricky, isn't it?
I think it's there.
Yeah. So take the club in your left hand. Release that with your right. And then pull out. Club onto the ground. Check the club face to your grip. You good?
Yep.
Yeah?